to get data from a text or CSV file into Power Query, you'll just go to the data ribbon. You'll see there are some shortcuts here, but I'm going to go this way, get data from file, and you'll see there's an option here saying from text slash CSV. When you click on it, you'll get the normal navigation. You just have to navigate towards it. So I'm going to choose that one there. When I say import, you'll see that this screen appears. Because the file is a CSV, Excel has guessed a bit. You'll see it's decided on the origin. It's then decided that it thinks the delimiter is a comma and shown you what it will look like. If you disagree, what you can do is choose something else, or you can choose a custom. So if I choose custom, let's use something crazy like a zero, for example. You'll see it then assumes that that's how it's gonna break up. But we know it's definitely not a zero, it's a comma. It also then gives you the option of how it should detect the data type. So it has looked at the first 200 rows here and decided it's a comma. But as you can see, there are some other ways that you can do this. Once you're happy with this, you'll notice down here you've got a button to load. So what this would do is bring it in and bring it straight back into Excel. Or we can say edit, which is where we go into the Power Query window. So we're going to click edit. Once you're here, you can now start performing all the transformations you need to do. We just want to emphasize something. Once you've brought it in, you'll notice that the applied steps has two steps to it. So there's something called source and change type. If I click on source, this is how it got in to Power Query. And you'll see there's a little gearbox or setting here. So if for whatever reason, you've done all this work, you've then gone, you've cleaned stuff up, etc., and then you decide that this actually is looking at the wrong place, we can click on our little gearbox settings here, and you'll see it brings us back to the screen, a couple of familiar options, but most importantly, you'll see there's the browse option, which means I can then go and perhaps change it to a different file.